destroy the Jedi Knights. The Old Republic is crippled. They can do nothing to stop us now. But there is one thing standing in our way. One last Jedi who has yet to choose his true role in the galaxy. If he joins us on the path to darkness, those who fight alongside him will follow. But if he takes the path of a Jedi, those who join him will feel the vengeance of the dark side.
Anticipated sequel to the 2003 Game of the Year, Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic 2, The Sith Lords.
And welcome to a new Let's Play at Star Wars Knights of the Republic 2. That's right, finally doing it. I'm going to up the brightness just a little bit. And there is Republic Commando, I was right, it was Quarter 2. So this is Star Wars Knights Republic 2, this is actually the first Quarter game that I played, and it's literally one of my favourite, most fondest childhood memories. So we're going to start a new game here on normal. So, we actually start the game off as a Jedi. There is none of this slowly becoming a Jedi, we start off as a Jedi in this game. And we have the same ones, we have Jedi Counselor, Sentinel, and Guardian. And we can also be either a male or a female. Now, I'm going to be playing this game canon style, so I'm going to go with a female. And I went with a Sentinel last game. I'm going to go with a Guardian this time. Jedi Guardians focus on combat training and lightsaber mastery, so I'm going to try out a little bit different and rely on our party members from over the skills. So we're not going to go with quick character because that will just give you a bunch of stuff. We're going to go with custom. We're going to pick our own portrait. That's a possibility, that one there. As is that. Very good portraits here. Got to pick a good portrait. Oh, I like that one actually. Going with that one. There we go, there's our portrait. Now let's do our attributes. Attributes of your character apply bonuses or penalties to everything from combat to skill checks to force powers. Check each attribute to see what aspects of gameplay it can affect. So, for those of you who have not played the game, let me just go over this with you. We've got everything right now is a modifier of negative 1, which I'm not happy with. We have 30 points to put in. So let me just get everything to not a negative. That's my first goal, so that we're not negative anything. So we've got strength, dexterity, constitution, intelligence, wisdom, charisma. Strength is measures your physical power. High strength adds modifiers to melee damage and chance to hit, which is important for characters who use close combat weapons, such as us. Dexterity basically makes it makes your character harder to hit. It makes you more flexible. Constitution gives you more health and HP, as well as determining what kind of implants you can gain access to. Intelligence represents how many skill points you get. Skill points aren't as important in this game though as they were in Quarter 1. Wisdom talks about your force powers effectiveness and your force points. Charisma increases the potency of a character's force powers. It also reduces penalty. So if you were a light side character and using a dark side power, high charisma would lower the penalty for using that. And it also improves your companion's chance to hit. So charisma is very useful. But because we're a guardian, I'm going to go with the strength of 16. Give a +1, +1 to all them. I might give I may, because I'm a guardian, I'm not going to be using skills, so I'm going to have my intelligence down 8. Charisma is not that important. I'm also going to put charisma. Charisma down to that so I can focus on. Constitution. See, we don't really want too much dexterity because we're going to be a tank basically. So let me just up my constitution. I'm actually going to re-up that. And up that and up that. Now we've got 2 more points. I can't actually up strength anymore. So I'll up constitution. Oh, I can't. I need 2 more points up my constitution. I need 4. So I think I'll reduce my wisdom by 2 and use that to put my constitution up to 16. So strength of 16, dexterity of 12, constitution 16, intelligence of 8, wisdom 10, and charisma 12. Let me just finish off my burger here before we actually go any further. Okay. So, what I have here, pardon me, is all of our skills for the game. Now, each class specializes in different skills. As a Jedi Guardian, we get to specialise in demolitions, awareness, persuade, and treat injury. We do not specialise in security, repair, stealth, or computer use. Skills are a little bit less important in this game, and the one that you really want to focus on is persuade. I'm going to put 2 in persuade, because we are going to be doing a lot of persuading in the game, because we're the only character that can persuade, but we do want other skills, so I do want at least 1 in security, maybe 1 in awareness. I need at least 1 in demolitions. This is annoying. I definitely need at least 1 point in security. I think I'm going to put 1 in awareness instead, actually, I think. See, it's all about balance. It's all about balancing your skills and your attributes. I am happy with that. Now, feats. This is where we're going to have tons of feats. So we've already got armor proficiency in light and medium armor. We get critical strike, flurry, and power attack. Power Blast, Rapid Shot, and Sniper Shot, Weapon Proficiency, Blaster Pistol, Rifle, Lightsabre, Melee Weapons, Jedi Defense. We get a lot of stuff right off the bat. So this base, these 3 here, Armor Proficiency, basically allows us to wear different sets of armor. We've got Critical Strike, Flurry and Power. These are all kind of combat maneuvers. We can use Melee Weapons and Pistols, we can use all of these. We won't get Lightsabres for a while. Yeah, we've got Jedi Defense. What does Jedi Defense do? Oh, that's about deflecting blaster bolts, which is kind of useful. Force Jump is a Jedi Guardian only, but you need a lightsaber to use it. Jedi Sense. Defense bonuses, awesome. Okay, so close combat, regenerate. So we could actually make our character get class skills. If we really feel so, if I really feel we need to get security as a class skill, I may actually, but I'm probably not. Dual strike, blah, 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 blah. That's pretty good actually. Finesse. I've not actually played this game in a long time, and I'm intending to play this game extremely seriously. It's mastered using grace and speed of melee weapons. Either either dexterity, whichever is higher. That's pretty good, actually, if you've got a higher dexterity and strength, but we've got a higher strength and dexterity. So what are we going to want from the get-go? What is our first thing that we want? The first thing that I think we want to get is probably two weapon fighting, because I'm going to be using two weapon fighting. I'm going to get two weapon fighting to begin with. Only one feat for now, which is annoying, but we'll get a lot more. Okay, so I'm going to actually name the character the name that is actually the expanded universe's name. Mitra. Surik. And that is the expanded universe's name for the Exile, our character. We're playing canon. So now let's jump right in. So as a Jedi Guardian, we are a little bit vulnerable without our... Well, not vulnerable, but we're going to have difficulty using skills without our party members. And the first little section of the game really is focused on solo stuff. I might skip this because I don't want to get hit with copyright, but I'm going to chance it. Definitely going to lower the volume here, however. The Sith Lords. It is a perilous time for the galaxy. A brutal civil war has all but destroyed the Jedi Order, leaving the alien republic on the verge of collapse. Amid the turmoil, the evil Sith have spread across the galaxy, hunting down and destroying the remaining Jedi Knights. Narrowly escaping a deadly Sith ambush, the last known Jedi clings to life aboard a battered freighter near the ravaged world of Paragus. My channel is actually going to become quite Star Wars focused for the next while. I've got a lot of Star Wars games I want to do, so it's going to be quite Star Wars focused for the next while. Hope you guys enjoy. Here we go. Got a tutorial section to begin with. It's the Ebon Hawk from the last game. Not looking too good though. T3M4! Who remembers this little guy?
The Ebon Hawk is adrift in space after a terrible battle. Most of its crew are dead or dying. You lie in the medical room in critical condition. You won't survive long without medical attention. The hyperdrive is damaged. Main power must be restored in order to bring the engines online and dock with the nearby Paragus mining station for much needed.
So we could skip the prologue, but just in case you guys aren't actually aware of how this game works, I'm going to do the prologue tutorial. T3M4, let's actually press and we'll pause game. Okay, and so white button pauses game, black button changes party members. We've not got any party members, however. Here we go, this is the start menu. The first thing we've got is our equipment. He's got a droid shock arm equipped. usable by T3. Can you unlimited use, and it's a very good piece of equipment, especially against droids. This is just showing all of our stuff that we've got. Equip screen, inventory screen, character screen. This will tell us what T3M4 is like. He's got 10 strength, 15 dexterity, constitution 14, intelligence 16, so he's mostly a skill character. Not too great in combat, and definitely going to be blasters. Abilities, computer use, yep, that's what we can see from, let's see, he's got 6 computer use, pretty good. 2 demolitions, awareness, no one will have persuade, no one apart from you and your entire party, repair. So he's really good in skills. And these are your potential party members. As you can see, there is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There's about 10 of them there. So, we've only got T3, a little T3 M4 right now. This is our journal, and here's our map. So we can see the Ebon Hawk. We're in the cockpit at the moment with the galaxy map. And that's the Ebon Hawk. So if you've played the first game, then you'll know all about the Ebon Hawk and how to control. This is just for those who potentially haven't played the first game. So your stances, these are new to the game. We can either be stationary, which means we attack but don't move, do not switch weapons, ranged, which is for ranged people, aggressive, which means to pursue, and all these different, like, basically combat stances. So T3 will be arranged. Awesome. So basically we can't use the, this is our galaxy map, lets us go places. We can't use it though until we fix our hyperdrive. And we've got a quest. Let's see what our quest is. Prologue, save the Ebon Hawk. The Ebon Hawk is heavily damaged and adrift in a dangerous asteroid field. Find the hyperdrive and fix it to restore primary power so that you can dock with the Paragus mining station for repairs. Bonus mission. Mitra Surik is lying in the med bay in critical condition. You can use a med pack to stabilize her vitals. To fully heal, Mitra will require the facilities at Paragus. So let's go about doing that, Alice. So, these are containers. We can open them up and get stuff. There's a computer spike. And here's a communications console that we need to slice into the system in order to open the door. So thankfully I just picked up a spike. So we've sliced into the Ebon Hawk using that spike, and now we've opened the door using up that spike. So that's how computer slicing works. Well, something's banging on there. Well, that's kind of creepy. Who the hell's in there? We've got a footlocker. Let's use our security to open it up. So, some containers will have just a security that is impossible, which means the only way to open them up is to bash them. Now, bashing works differently in Quarter 2 than it did in Quarter 1. In Quarter 1, you could bash open any footlocker you wanted with no repercussions, but now, you get broken items. So, broken items are obviously useless. So, having a broken item in your inventory is not too great. Let's slice the computer, slice them, the security system, and we can access the cameras. Let's look at all the outer garage door, inner garage door, engine room, there's the engine room, and there's our utility lift. What about, can we open any security doors? Engine room door, inner garage door working, outer garage door working, okay. So, we'll have to use this at some point. We've got a body here, with a locker key. More parts, which is always handy. Can't open that door just yet. So let's head down on here and see what's up. Can't open that door just yet. Really, I usually skip the prologue, but I'm keeping it here for you guys in case you haven't played this game before. Cargo hold, where we keep all of our stuff. So let's open this door, this locker. And we get a computer spike, armor, and parts. Awesome. So let me just equip this armor, which gives us a defense bonus of 3. So that's awesome. We want that on T3. Let's get this plasteel cylinder. Parts with the security tunneler. Security tunnelers are quite good. All you need is a security skill of 1 to use them. And they can help you get... for instance, if your skill is too low, you can use a security tunneler to boost your security skill temporarily and get through. Let me now get all that stuff. Field survival pistol. This is a little combat tutorial.
Sensor droids emerge from this box when you open
it. Really? Really? Wow, I didn't know that.
Use the weapon from this container.
Right, okay. Let me just show off combat. Equip our pistol. Right, okay, we know. I'm actually just going to use my droid. Because I can use this shock stick as many times as I want. And they're amazing for destroying droids. So you can do that as many times as you want, but I don't know why you would want to.
Talking to other characters is much like using the computer console. Note that some responses may furthermore, certain skills, powers, and attributes may modify.
I'll explain all this as I go. So we've got 3 CEFD. So let's repair him using a part. And now we have this guy. Let's invite him to our party. And now we got him in our party. Right, great, I know that. Now, where do I need to go? Engine room? Can I go into the engine room? Door, da 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 da. I have to find it. Oh, great, I need an explosive trap. Can I come into. Right, okay, tutorial, you're getting on my nerves now. So here's our main character.
You are in critical condition. You will need a med pack to be stabilized.
I'm gonna need a med pack. Open up the medical storage bin and get a med pack.
The med pack can...
And use the med pack on myself.
Success. You are stabilized. To recover.
Great, so now my character's not gonna die and we get 100 experience points for that. So there is a little, there is a couple of benefits to doing this prologue, but really, it's just annoying for the most part. Right, so let's activate solo mode, which basically means that T3 will walk about and 3CFD will not follow him. And now let's use 3CFD to open up the garage outer door. No, that you open up. Close the garage outer door. Nope, open it. I'm in the wrong place. So, I need to go. If I can move, we need to go down here towards the. Right in here. And use 3CFD. Close the outer and open the inner. And that's closed like that because, well, this is why it's closed. This place is. I don't like what's happened to my ship. And I can do that again basically from here. Although I don't know why I would want to. What benefit does it give me? Right, okay, so we can override that basically. So this basically allows, this basically takes us to a workbench. So let's use this workbench. Workbenches are different in this game. You can actually create items from scratch, which you weren't able to do using components. So we have two components. We can't create a field survival pistol or a secure tunnel or a computer spike, but we can make a repair kit, which we kind of need. We can break down items, so we can break down our two broken items to get more, and we can break down basically all this stuff. So we've got four components now, so we could make a field survival pistol if we wanted, but we're going to make a repair kit for little old, and hell, why not? Let's make a field survival pistol while we're at it, if we've got three components, and then use this repair kit on little poor T3M4, and now that that's done, let's get T3 back. And bring him down here, because we're going to have to go outside onto the hull of the ship. Let's cancel solo mode. And let's go. Okay, let's see what we've got. So let's go here first. Right, okay, I get it. So to recover mines, or even just disable mines, you need to have a demolition skill, which I personally don't have. So we can scavenge the quad lasers and get some parts. Oh, and containers actually now say empty once you've searched them and stuff, which is helpful. So let's recover these mines and get this proton metal, minor frag mine. Awesome! So that's basically everything we can do on this side. There's really not that much we can do in the prologue, but there is a couple of things. We can salvage some more parts. Got lots of parts. Lots and lots of parts. Okay, let's can I go over to that side? I don't think I can. Yo, 3CFD. Get out my damn way, man. Now, how do I remember there is a way that I can... Is it this? Yeah. Exposed wiring. Let's override that door, and now we can access that starboard dormitory. It's going to require us to do that annoying sequence again with the whole close the outer door, blah, blah, blah. But, I mean, there is some stuff in there that we want. So that's everything we need to do out here. So let's head back inside the Ebon Hawk. Right, okay. We'll do this annoying thing again quickly. Security doors. Close the outer. Open the inner. Go, 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 my friend. So, what did we get for all that? Parts. Not that great. And a droid flamethrower. That's actually quite good. Droid flamethrower is quite good, although it does have 10 uses. So, Now, I do want to see if I can maybe break down some of these parts, because what I want... I've got two computer spikes. I want a little bit more, so I need 12 components. Can I break down stuff? I need to keep one frag mine. I need to keep one of that. I get... How many do I get for breaking... Wow, okay, I get a lot of... Let me break down a lot of them. 44 components, okay, wow. That's a lot. Okay, so now I can create a bunch of stuff. I want as many of them as computer spikes as I can get. I'm gonna break down a couple more parts. One more. Let me get 8. Okay, because computer specs are really important, and they're also kind of important for something that I want to do early on in the game once we actually start. So let me just close the close that over and open. And by the way, everything that you collect in the prologue will carry over to your character once you start the game, which is why I was getting so many computer specs. Okay, now let's blow this joint. This is why I needed to keep one minor frag mine, so I could plant one and then walk away. And now we get in. Oops, I used too many parts, but that's okay, I've got plenty of... Oops, I got rid of too many parts, I don't need that many much more. It'll only take a quick trip back through, and I can get rid of stuff. That was my bad, guys. I was too intense on getting... parts, no, computer specs, that I got rid of too many parts. But this is the beauty of breaking down items. I only need one, to be honest, so can I even... Oh, I need 10. I need 10. Oh, that's not great. I might have to get rid of one. Right, there we go. I had to get rid of one computer spike. I hope I have enough computer spikes to do that thing. My computer skill is like zero at the moment. So now all we need to do is fix the hyperdrive.
The hyperdrive, however,
with 5 parts.
Only one step.
And now that we're done, all we need to do is go all the way up to the cockpit and set our route for Paragus, however you want to say it.
You can now plot.
Let's go. Looks like we made it. Please don't shoot us. We've been shot up enough already.
The sensors show the door to the storage compartment is being sliced. There is someone or something else alive on the Ebon Hawk.
Who the hell is in this ship? Is that HK-47? That's that! We're now into the game. Let's check out our... we've completed that, so successfully docked with the Paragus, done all that. Created repair kit, stabilized meter, we've repaired seat, we've done all that. So now, Paragus 2, you've been awakened in a medical bay in an unknown facility. The last thing you remember is being in a passenger on the Republic capital ship, the Harbinger. You should find out where you are and how you got here, but we're going to wait till next episode. We're going to make our first save of the game. And we're going to end this episode because it's been kind of a long episode. So thank you guys very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope you come back for more Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic 2. I have been Radiant at 5. If you've enjoyed, please consider leaving a like and subscribing to my channel for even more content. I also now stream on Twitch. So if you want to see me there, you can see me there. See you guys later.